down on the bottom left, does it say share?
Yep.
Yeah. And then start watch
party?
Yes. And then you can type in whatever you want there. Like your PayPal, Venmo, thanks so much, whatever, hello, hi, how are you doing? And then hit start. And but the thing is, they'll be able to hear us right now, but they can't see us. I'm just going to leave the audio on because it kind of gives people a little... so they're not sitting in silence, so to speak.
First few minutes is people just kind of joining the party.
Yeah, and that's why I like to leave the audio hot, just so it gives them something to listen to while they sit up. Because I used to keep it muted, and Andy was like, try it out. People like the chatter. It's like a real live gig. I'm going to leave that there whenever you pull your guitar up, I'll position it. And this guy right here. Do you need vocals on that set? Do you want that this name on that set too?
Yeah, it depends.
Both would be best, right?
We'll bring this one in a little closer.
Yeah, yeah.
And then put this kind of close to the guitar body, right?
Right. And,
okay,
and I'm going to adjust
this
one's
it. Over on that side.
All right, cool. And I'll adjust that.
I'm going to change my shirt real quick.
Thank you.
control before I start too, if that's okay.
Definitely. Yeah, let's just, let me see what you're sounding like. Because I want to get that microphone on the right place just in case.
Tell me, are you ready for me to start strumming? You said you were going to turn the lights down behind me. Vocal mic too close to me. Yeah, okay. Not right about there. Can you see the monitor, the camera yet? See the guitar?
All I know is something like a bird within her sign. All I know, she sang a little while and then flew on. You know, I'll show you snow and rain. If you see that same sweet song again, will you know why?
And the lights behind me, like, down a little bit, maybe. I'll just kind of be strumming on something, okay? I don't know if you can see me out there yet, people, but we're about to go live any second. I'm here at the Sidebar NOLA. All right. Are we ready, Keith? We are live here at Sidebar NOLA. Thanks for joining me, everybody. It's been about a month since I've done one of these live streams, maybe a little longer than that. In that month's time, I've
Gotta tell you, this isolation has been getting to me a little bit. Sometimes I start to feeling like my musical career is something that's gonna be on hold for a very long time. And because of that, I wanna remind everybody to please wear your mask so that we can get through this thing quicker. I hope you're doing all right. I hope everybody's healthy and staying safe and staying sane. Tonight I'm going to do an entire set of songs written by Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia. And I know some of you who might be familiar with the other side of my career might be wondering, well, Papa Malley, you know, we know you as a Louisiana artist. We know you as somebody that's done swamp music and voodoo blues, and yeah, that's still me. You might say, well, there's lots of people out there doing Grateful Dead music, why are you just doing that? Well, I have a reason for it, because I was friends with Robert Hunter, and I was in a band with Billy Kreutzmann. Kreutzmann introduced me to Hunter about 12 years ago. We wrote a bunch of songs together, stayed in touch right up until he passed away last year. So I have a special place in my heart for Robert Hunter, and I've always loved the music that him and Jerry made together. Tonight, that's what we're going to do. Robert Hunter's birthday is in the late part of June, so we just passed that, and Jerry Garcia's birthday is coming up in just a couple of weeks, so this is what I'm calling the Days Between set, the Days Between Their Birthdays. This first song I'm going to play is one that I had the great pleasure of playing with Robert Hunter out in his backyard by his swimming pool while his mother, who was in her 90s, she was listening. We had been playing a bunch of old blues and country songs, and she finally came up and she said, Robert, play one of your songs. And this is the song we played, and she sang along on the choruses. This is called, you know the song.
That it takes a lot to win, even more to lose. You and me bound to spend some time just wondering what to choose. Goes to show that you don't ever know. So watch each card you play and play it slow. Wait until that deal come round. Don't you let that deal go down. I've been gambling hereabouts for 10 good solid years. If I told you all that I know, it would burn off both your ears. Goes to show that you don't ever know. Watch each card you play and play it slow. Wait until that deal come around. Don't you let that deal. Goes to show you don't ever know. Watch each card you play and play it slow. Wait until that. Since you poured the wine for me, tightened up my shoes. Had to leave you standing here, composing lonesome blues. Goes to show that you don't ever know. Watch each card you play it slow. Wait until that deal come round. Don't you let that deal. Until that deal comes.
Don't you let that deal go down. All right. We're not wasting any time here. We're just going to go from song to song so I can get to as many of your requests as possible here. Any of you deadheads out here in the audience tonight, you already know this, but for those of you who are just casually acquainted with the music of Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia, this is one that was written for the late, great Janis Joplin. Is something like a bird within her sang. All I know, she sang a little while and then flew on. All that you know, I'll show you snow. Would you hear that same sweet song again? Will you know why? Anyone who sings so sweet, a tune is passing by. Thank you. She sang a little while and then flew on. Tell me all that you know, I'll show you snow and rain. We do have a few employees and friends of employees that are safe distancing, so that's why you hear some applause every now and then. You guys can applaud, it's okay. Makes it feel a little bit more live in here. So that last song was first featured on Jerry Garcia's first solo album, simply titled Garcia. And I got to be really good friends with Billy Kreutzmann during the 5 years that we were playing together and traveling together and touring together. And, that sounds better. And he shared this with me that that album, which so many of the songs on that album became Grateful Dead staples over the years, but it was actually just Jerry and Billy and Hunter in the studio, just the three of them together. And Billy played the drums, and Jerry played all the other instruments, keyboards, bass, guitars. Hunter was actually writing the lyrics while they were in the studio. And those songs ended up being some of the most classic Jerry Garcia, Robert Hunter, Grateful Dead tunes of all time. Dead & Company still plays most of them. And so that was pretty incredible to me that they could just go into a studio and just create something like that with just the three of them. This next song is also on that record. It's one that has not been covered as often. I think the Dead have done it a few times, but not a lot. And I'm going to do it for you tonight because I think it's always been one of my favorites. So. To lay me down once more, to lay me down, with my head in sparkling clover, let the world go by, all lost in dreaming, to lay me down one last time, to lay me down. Be with you
once more to be with you. If our bodies close together, let the world go by.
So now I'm gonna dig deep. If I'm, let's see, let me make sure this is the right one. Oh yeah, this is one that one of the first, really one of the very first Grateful Dead songs that back when I was still just a teenager, and me and my buddies would take mushrooms or take acid and listen to Grateful Dead records. This one always just struck me as being so unusual and peculiar, and it's also, it's the one that they chose to play when they were on Hugh Hefner's Playboy After Dark show, which there's also a story behind that, as most of you deadheads already know, but for those that you don't know, this was back in about 68, I think, maybe, something like that, and they were invited to play on, Hugh Hefner had this television show which was supposed to look like a cocktail party, and he would invite his, you know, everybody just kind of sitting around in his, like, Playboy pad, you know. And then they would have people like the Grateful Dead. Like Joe Cocker was on there one time. I saw some other, you know, lots of other people. You know, but then, again, you'd have, like, all these other, like, kind of jet-setter-type celebrities. I remember, you know, Don Adams was kind of a regular. We'd be hanging around wearing tuxedos, drinking martinis, and all these kind of, like, fancy people.
fancy it for the 60s. But the Grateful Dead came on the show, and of course, everywhere they went, you know, Ozzie Stanley was just dosing as many people as he possibly could. And in this particular case, they put some liquid LSD in the coffee urn, and all of these kind of like cosmopolitan jet set Playboy people just got a big dose of it. And Jerry's just sitting on the couch wearing this kind of funky looking poncho. You can look it up on YouTube. And this is the song that he played. And I've always liked it. I've just thought it sounds like something almost from like a medieval times, but also very kind of a psychedelic edge to it. So hopefully I'll get through it. This is called Mountains of the Moon. Mountains of the moon, Electra, mountains of the moon. I hope the carrion cold, falderaldy riddle. I hope the carrion crow, now and bend to me.
Da 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 da
transient nightfall of diamonds. Half
some motherfuckers crying. The other half found me stumbling round, drunk on burgundy wine. Dying days in. I said to him, I'm sure she's been. Shooting.
That one is one called Wharf Rat. Another one of the great Jerry Garcia, Robert Hunter songs. That's all we're doing here tonight, folks, in case you're just joining us. My name is Papa Molly. Hopefully you know that already. But if not, have yourself a seat. Get yourself a nice refreshment of some sort. We got a lot more music to go, and I'm playing all of the music of Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia because we are in between what would have been Robert's birthday about a week, about a little over a week ago, and Jerry's birthday coming up in about 2 weeks. So we're doing a days between birthday celebration of Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia. I'm going to do one right now that I've been doing for a while. This is actually one that also off of that album that I told you about that was Garcia's first solo album. And it's become so ingrained in the Grateful Dead's live repertoire for so many years now that many people forget that it was one of those wonderful classic songs that came off that first Garcia solo album. This one actually had a little bit of inspiration when I was writing. I wrote some songs with Robert Hunter. I think I mentioned that earlier. And one of the very first song I wrote was one called The King Cotton Blues, which we later got to record with Willie Nelson, which was a great honor. And this is when I was trying to think of, Robert Hunter sent me the lyrics for the song, and I was just trying to come up with the music. And I was inspired by, I didn't realize it until later, but I was a little bit inspired by this, which is one of my favorite Robert Hunter, Jerry Garcia songs. It's called The Loser.
Thank you.
Everybody's praying and drinking that wine. I can tell the Queen of Diamonds by the way she shines.
Y'all can make some noise. All right. Well, a lot of the songs I've been choosing tonight, at least a few of them, have been kind of deep cuts from Robert and Jerry. I'm gonna go for one now that's very familiar. It's been, I think it's one of their most famous songs, and it's also one of their really good feel-good songs. And also, it's just a great song. It's just like an amazing song. So if you're sitting at home, when we get to the end of it, if you feel like singing along, go right ahead and sing along. Get one more sip of my little beverage here. By the way, if you're having a beverage out there, let's lift a glass together.
Cheers.
That's something we don't get to do much anymore. You know, let's go out and sit at bars or restaurants with our friends and say, cheers. So here we go. Cheers. My words did glow with the gold of sunshine, and my tunes were played on the harp unstrung. Would you hear my voice come through the music? Would you hold it near? It were your own, it's a hand-me-down. The thoughts are broken, perhaps they're better left unsung. I don't know, don't really care. Still water when there is no pebble tossed, no wind to blow. Reach out your hand if your cup is empty, if your cup is full, may it be again. There is a fountain that was not made by the hands of men. There is a road, no simple highway, between the dawn and the dark of night.
go. No one may follow. That path is for your steps alone. Ripples in the still water, where there is no choose to must follow. But if you fall, you fall alone. Should you stand, then who's to guide you? If I knew the way,
sing along at home, all right?
Na 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 da. Na 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 da da. Na na da. Na na da. Na da da da. Na da 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 da.
Choked up on that one. I don't know. I must have felt your vibes at home, because that was kind of a moment for me. Ooh. All right. Where are we now, y'all? Let's see. Oh. You know, I skipped one early on. I think I'll do it. It's another one of those songs off the same album, off the American Beauty record. That a lot of people love this song as well. It's a very popular song written by Hunterin Garcia. I'm sure you'll recognize it. Even if you're not a big Grateful Dead fan, you'll know this one. By the way, I sure appreciate all of you sending your tips. This is how we musicians make a living now. Strange as it is, it's all we got. And I just can't imagine living in a world where I can't play my songs for y'all.
I lit out from Reno. I was trailed by 20 hounds. I didn't get sleep that night till the morning came around. Set out running, but I take my time. Friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. I ran into the devil, and he loaned me 20 bills. I spent the night in Utah in a cave up in the hills. I said I'd run and but I take my time. Friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. I went down to the levee, but the devil met me there. He took my $20 bill and he vanished in the air. Said I'd run, but I'd take my time. A friend of the devil, a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Got two reasons why I cry away each lonely night. She's my heart's delight. Second one is prison, baby. The sheriff's on my trail. And if he catches up with me, I spend my life in jail.
child, but it don't look like me. I set out running, but I take my time. Friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. And I haven't been getting a lot of sleep lately. I don't know about y'all, but my sleep is all fucked up.
Thank you. Keith, you suppose I could get a little refill here on my Puro de Agave,
Puro.
Muchas gracias. All right. So, this is the portion of the show where I encourage all of you that have been kind of hedging on it. I know a lot of y'all have already just been so generous, and without your tips and without your donations, there's just no way that me and so many musicians could be surviving right now. The crazy thing is that a lot of us aren't eligible for things that most people are, like unemployment, because we've always been kind of living on the fringe of that thing. So, you know, I was, before the pandemic, I was doing just fine. I've had like a 40-year career, and I've over the years I've worked my way up to a point where I'm not going to say that I was like, you know, living large or anything, but I was able to get by. I was able to pay my bills. I was able to pay my car note, my mortgage, and just on my music alone. And that's been going on for many, 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 many years. And the reason that I just stopped doing these live streams about a month ago is because I started getting this kind of sinking feeling that, like, here I am after all these years of working to build a career slowly and being perfectly happy at the level that I was at. You know, I never really had aspirations of being any kind of big star or being rich or famous. I just wanted to play music, and I wanted to travel, and I wanted to make new friends and play music for people. That's all I really want to do, make records. And suddenly, within like a matter of 2 days, I lost all of the scheduled income that I had, you know, for the entire summer and into the fall. And I'm sure a lot of you guys did too, so I'm not like harping on that, because I know everybody's going through tough times. But about a month ago, I just started feeling like, man, it's just feeling more and more and more like I'm just asking for a handout, and I just did not feel good to me to be doing that. But a friend of mine, you know, saw that I was feeling really down about it and kind of getting really, like, you know, I don't know, just like reclusive almost, not even answering the phone, not even replying to text messages from friends, from family. And he said, you know, you're providing music at a time when we all need music. So there's a human connection, you know, that I feel with you, and I hope you feel with me. And
So this is how I'm going to do my gigs now. And just like I would charge a cover charge at the door, I'm not going to do that online because I want everybody to be here. And I know that everybody's got limited funds these days. Maybe not everybody, but a lot of you do. So just if you got a little something you can give, that's great. If you got a lot of something you can give, even better. But I do appreciate it, and it is helping me right now when I need it. So that's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to mention it again the rest of the show. Get back to the music, because that's really what I like doing the best anyways, playing music and not asking for money. So, but thank you so much for all your contributions. Really, really appreciate it. All right. This is one also off the American Beauty record. And then we're going to move on into some stuff that came after that. Still got a long ways to go, if that's cool with y'all. I'm having a good time. I'm in no hurry to leave.
Pretty women with your hair hanging down. Open up your windows, 'cause the candy man's in town. Come on, boys, and wager. Roll those laughing. 7 come 11, boys, I'll take your money home. Look out, the candy man. Here he comes, then he's gone again. Pretty lady ain't got no friend till the candy man come around. In from Memphis, where I learned to talk the jive. When I get back to Memphis, there'll be one less man alive. Good morning, Mr. Benson. I see you're doing well. If I had me a shotgun, I'd blow you straight to hell. Look out, the candy man. Here he comes, then he's gone again. Pretty lady ain't got no friend till the candy man comes around. Come on, boys, and wager. If you've got the mind, if you've got a dollar, won't you lay it on the line? guitar and the whiskey down. Won't you tell everybody you meet that the candy man's in town? Look out, look out, the candy man. Here he comes, then he's gone again. Pretty lady ain't got no friend till the candy man comes around again. Look out, the candy man. Here it comes, and it's gone again. Pretty lady ain't got no friend till the candy man comes around.
As I mentioned before, we don't actually have a live audience tonight here at the Sidebar in New Orleans, but we do have some employees and a couple of friends of employees that are nice enough to sit here and listen and give me a hand when I finish the song. So give yourselves a hand. Come on, let me hear you. Let me hear you. All right. Woo-hoo. Makes it feel a little bit more live in here, even though we're safe distancing and they've all got masks on. I did have a mask on right up until the time that that we went live, so it's kind of hard to sing with a mask on, but I'm being careful, and we're sanitizing everything. I hope you're being careful out there, too. We want to get through this pandemic alive, and we want to get through it as quickly as possible. So believe in it, man. There's people dying. There's lots of people dying every day, people going into hospitals every day, and not enough hospital equipment. I'm not trying to bring you down. I just want to say if you're one of those people that still think, well, is it real? Yeah, it's real, man. It's real. It's real. It's real. Okay. Let's see. I know one I want to play. This is one because it is one of those. This is one of the, you know, the thing about the Dead that was so great, and the reason that they sustained such a loyal following for so many years is they would bring everybody along with them on their journey, you know? It's like they, you know, Billy Kreutzmann to me is like one of the greatest drummers that ever lived. He really, you know, his heroes were like Elvin Jones and you know, like some of the great drummers of New Orleans, like Zigaboo Modalese, those were his heroes. But he basically developed his style on the gig. He was so young when those guys started out, and he told me he was listening to lots of Fats Domino records, and he was listening to lots of records that Earl Palmer played on, like the Little Richard stuff. And his mother was from New Orleans, which is one of the ways that he and I first initially connected. Very randomly, really. I was playing at Oregon Country Fair, and I had never met him before. And he came to my show and made a point of coming backstage to introduce himself to me. I was just coming off stage, and I did not even recognize the dude. I didn't recognize him. I was a big Dead fan back when I was younger, but it had been years since I'd really followed them, and he was just seemed like this nice, cool guy that was talking to me, and we were talking about things that we both loved, like New Orleans music and fishing, and both of our mothers are from New Orleans and that sort of thing. It wasn't until about 20, 30 minutes later that I realized that who he was, and because the only way I realized that is because this big crowd of people had gathered around us, and I've told this story many times before, so if you've heard it before, I apologize. But it was quite remarkable because we were at the Oregon Country Fair, which is it's a piece of property that once was somehow either Ken Kesey owned it or he did events out there or something like that, but it was a Merry Prankster hotspot. It was a place where the Dead played some of their greatest early shows. And for me to just randomly meet Bill like that, and then this is the crazy part, too, is that, like, we hit it off so good that within 90 minutes after we met, he asked me, you know, you want to drop some acid? And I was like, man, you know, I haven't taken acid in years. And he said, well, trust me, if you're ever going to do acid again in your life, this is the best acid you'll ever have or ever have had. And something about the way he said it, I just said, yeah, you know what? Let's go. So off we went. And we ended up just like being buddies like the rest of the weekend, hanging out together. And then soon after that, we started playing music together. We started a band together. He introduced me to Robert Hunter. Robert Hunter and I started writing songs together. And Robert and I stayed friends right up until the time that he died. We stayed connected via email, and he would send me lyrics, and I would try to write music to them. Still got a bunch of unreleased songs that Hunter sent me that I'm going to release one of these days. And then it just broke my heart when he passed away, because I always wanted his approval, and he had approved a few of them, but several of them he hadn't heard yet. So I'm gonna try to see if his spirit will tell me that it's okay to release him. Anyway, that's another story. I'm not sure how I got off on all that, except to say that this is why I feel such a special connection to this music, and it's not just another guy trying to jump on that bandwagon. I wasn't even a Deadhead at all when Billy met me. I didn't even recognize him. Since then, I've learned so much about the Grateful Dead. Like I say, I listened to a lot of Dead when I was young, like a teenager. Even went and saw the Dead in like 74, or tried to see them, and then I saw them a few years later. The first time I tried to see them, they canceled. But anyway, I did get to see them with Jerry a few times, and that was amazing. But then after that, especially after Jerry died, I just kind of didn't pay any attention to it at all. But since then, I've been educated a lot by all the Deadheads. Deadheads aren't like regular music fans. They don't come up and mob you. They come up, they're real cool, they're real friendly. They try to give you drugs a lot of the time, which is sometimes it's welcome. Sometimes it's like, oh, no, man, thanks, no thanks. But anyway, it's always nice to get a little weed, you know. But anyway, I've learned a lot, but it's like I say, it wasn't a thing where I went out and tried to learn all the songs of the Grateful Dead or tried to play guitar like Jerry. In fact, I think that if I had been that kind of guy, that Bill and Hunter wouldn't have had any interest in me whatsoever, because there's a lot of guys like that, and much respect to some of them. They do it really well, but that's not me. I do my own thing with it. I'm going to try to carry on their tradition every once in a while as best I can, and then I'll get back to my own music for a little while. But tonight we're celebrating Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia. This is one of my favorites because I was born in Vicksburg, Mississippi, and I was raised here in Louisiana from the time I was 3 years old. But as B.B. King told me one time, I got to tour with B.B. King, opened for him on two tours. And he told me, he said, Papa, where are you from? I said, well, I'm from Louisiana. He said, no, where are you really from? And I said, well, I was born in Mississippi. He said, I knew it. Us Mississippi boys got to stick together. So ever since he told me that, I always, you know, be sure and mention the fact that I am originally from Mississippi, moved to Shreveport. My parents moved to Shreveport when I was 3, and my mom was here from New Orleans, so I got to spend a lot of time in New Orleans growing up, too. And now I've been living in New Orleans for going on 10 years now. Back here again, mm-hmm. I should say. I lived here back in the 80s for a little while. Late 70s for a little while, and then back here again. Anyway, long, long stories. I'm going to get to the song right now. Hopefully I didn't lose all of you. And if I did, come back, because this is one called Mississippi Half Step. I'm going to tune the guitar real quick, too, because I think it's falling out of tune just a bit. Maybe you want to hit the AC for a second while I'm tuning.
There you go.
Because it's getting really warm in here. That's why the guitar is going out of tune.
Yeah, you're right.
The AC is really loud in here. That's why I asked him to turn it off. This will only take a few minutes, but hopefully it'll cool it down in a minute. This would be a good time for anybody to take a little intermission if they need one, but please come back. We got a bunch of good songs coming up. We got Mississippi Half Step. We got Ramble on Rose. We got Stella Blue. A lot more. So come back. I'm going to tune the guitar. Be back here in about, well, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just going to sit here and tune for about 3 or 4 minutes. Thank you.
If you're just tuning in and you missed everything that came before, I'll give you a quick rundown of the set list that you missed, and you can always go back and watch it. These things stay up for a while. We started out with Deal. We played Birdsong. We played To Lay Me Down, Friend, Mountains of the Moon, Into Dark Star, Into Wharf Rat. We played Loser. We played Ripple. We played Friend of the Devil, Candyman, and we're about to play Mississippi Half Step. By the way, if any of you are commenting live, I can't see your comments right now, but I always go back at the end of the night and read them all. So I do appreciate your words of encouragement. Certainly appreciate your tips and your donations, but if you can't afford that, which a lot of us can't, it's okay. And even if you just give a small little tip, that's fine too. Those add up. And if you can give a big one, wow, that's really great. Believe me, right now I need it. I hate, as much as I hate admitting that, it's true. My pride is not going to get in the way. So give what you can. I already said I'd shut up about that, so I am going to shut up about it. But if you can't afford it, just leave a little word of encouragement. Say, hey, Papa, hey, Malcolm, been a long time, you sound real good, or you suck. Anyway, man, I appreciate all of you. Starting to feel a little cooler in here. Let's let that cool air build up for a second, and then we'll turn it off and get back to the music. For any of you guitar freaks out there, I'm actually playing without any amplification tonight at all, just playing directly into this Sennheiser microphone and singing into this Shure 58. No amplification, no direct lines or anything like that. There's also a condenser mic in the room. And one of the reasons I love live streaming from here at the Sidebar is because this is one of my favorite places to play when there's not a pandemic going on. It's a very intimate room. You can't see it, but it only holds like maybe, I don't know, 50 people, something like that. One of the best bars in town. That's generous. Yeah, that's generous. 50 would be packed, 40 tops, 20 as a rule. It's a very intimate room, and I love playing here because it's a great place to try out new material and really, get a reaction from people. I can play quietly. I don't even have to bring an amplifier. I don't even have to plug in. I can just like being in somebody's living room. So I hope I'm welcome in your living room tonight. I hope you're still listening. We're going to get right back to the music here in just about 60 seconds, okay? Be patient. We need this little AC here for a second. The AC.
No, I did.
Okay.
It's on a delay.
Okay. All right, here we go. Take it away. Town, toodaloo. Hello, baby, I'm done.
all you've got to live for is what you left behind. Get yourself a powder charge and blow that silver mine. I left my boots in transit, babe. Mississippi uptown, toodaloo. Hello, baby, I'm gone. Goodbye. Half a cup of rock and roll. Farewell to you, oh, southern skies. I'm on my way, on my way. When your ship comes in, the first man takes the sails. The second takes the aft and then the third, the plank and rails. What's the use in keeping score? This queue ain't straight in line. Cue ball's made of styrofoam. Mississippi uptown, toodaloo. Hello, baby, I'm gone, goodbye. Half a cup of rock and roll. Farewell to you, oh, southern skies. I'm on my way, on my way, on my way.
Thank you, folks. We are so fortunate to have just a really, really cool dog in the studio with us. It's not a studio. It's actually a bar, but it feels like a studio because we got lights and cameras, and there's nobody here except the employees and their friends and So, but in Hubble is the name of the really cool dog that's in here. He makes me feel a lot more relaxed. Such a good vibe to have a good old dog. I'm playing the good old Grateful Dead music. Can you come on camera? Can you get on camera? Hubble, come here. Come here, Hubble. Yeah, that's a good. Oh, well. You might have seen the tip of his tail go by. I don't know. Hey, go say hi. It's okay. It's all right. Come here, Hubble. Come here. Anyway. All right. On to the next song. Let's see. Oh, yeah. We're going to do this one. This is like what I started to say. I know what I started to say a little while ago. I started talking about Bill Kreutzmann and how he had this natural ability to just make people dance. And part of it is because he learned to play the drums while they were developing their crowd. And it was a time when people would get together and they would, LSD was legal and they were having acid tests, and they would get together in a large room and with Ken Kesey and the Merry Pranksters, and they would do copious amounts of LSD, and the guys from the Dead would get on stage and they would play, and they would watch the people and they would get the vibe off the people, and that's how they developed their music, and that's how Bill developed his drumming style after learning from listening to R&B records and jazz records. But he could gauge the crowd and see how they were moving, and he could get them dancing. He could get those hippie kids, you know, doing their like improvised moves, you know, and he could get those Grateful Dead girls twirling, you know, he could pick up on that, and his style developed into something that was totally unique. And but then the thing that was so wonderful about Jerry was that he could take this crowd of people that had been dancing into like a fevered pitch, and then suddenly just quiet it all down with like this quiet, tender ballad, and just break people's hearts. And you know, and this is one of those songs that always touched me in that way. It's one that he wrote with Robert Hunter again. All the songs we're doing tonight are Hunter Garcia songs. And this is one called Stella Blue. And as I was practicing it today, I was just kind of realizing how much the lyrics were touching me today, because I've been kind of like a lot of you, I'm sure, have been going through some personal stuff where it's just like reassessing your life and everything that's led to this point and where we're going from here. But I hope that you all keep hope in your heart, because it was actually my fans and my friends and my family that kind of pulled me out of this blue funk that I've been in the last several weeks, and convinced me that I needed to really start playing again, which is really the essence of who I am. So this song really touched me when I started paying attention to the lyrics. I hope you like it. I hope you like my version of it anyway.
The years combined they melt into a dream. A broken angel sings from a guitar. In In the end, there's just a song. Comes crying like the wind through all the broken dreams and vanished years. Stella Blue. Stella Blue. When all the cards are down, there's nothing left to see. There's just the pavement left and broken dreams. In the end, there's still that song. Comes crying like the wind down every lonely street that's ever been. Stella Blue.
One that I've always personally loved a lot. I think the
first Grateful Dead record I bought was Live Dead. And then I bought, right after that, I went out, and like a week later, I went out and bought Europe 72, which had just come out. And that was, you know, back then I was a youngster, I was a teenager. I had to buy my records with my own money, by mowing lawns and stuff. And it was a good value because it was a triple record, you know. It's triple album, and at a good price. So I bought that one, and as it turns out, it was a really good. It stood the test of time. A lot of great songs off that record, and again, something a lot of people don't know is that Bill was the only drummer on that record because Mickey took a little time off during that period, and sometimes, you know, you listen to that and you go, wow, sounds like Bill's really playing great when. You know, and then where's Mickey? But wait, you know, it's like, wow, Bill's like playing Mickey's parts too. How's he doing that? But anyway, I love Europe 72. This is one off Europe 72.
Just like Jack the Ripper, just like Mojo Hand, just like Billy Sunday in a shotgun ragtime band, just like New York City, just like Jericho. Just like Crazy Otto, just like Wolfman Jack, sitting flush as a royal flush, aces back to back. Just like Mary Shelley, just like Frankenstein, clank your chains. Say your name was Ramblin' Rose. Ramble on, baby. Sat down easy. Ramble on, Rose.
song, it ain't never gonna end. I'm gonna march you up and down, all along the county line, take you to the leader of a band. So goodbye, Jack and Jill. The grass ain't greener, wine ain't sweeter, either side of the hill. Did you say your name was Ramblin' Rose? Ramble on, baby.
Where we at? We only got time for a couple more, I think. But there's some good ones. Oh, okay. We still got time for a couple more. We have two or three more. I hope you've enjoyed this time tonight that we spent together. I'm so glad we had this time together, just to laugh and maybe. That's a really, really old reference, and I'm really, really old. Okay. Carol Burnett, anybody? All right, Keith, uno mas, por favor, and that will be probably be my last one for this session. It is nice to sit here with you folks tonight. I know that some of you are probably just popping in and out. That's how I do it. I know, like, so many of my friends are doing live streams these days. I try to show support. I'll pop in for a few minutes and give them a little bit of love and say some things. I'll leave them a tip, and then I'll go on to something else, you know. But if you're happening to watch right now and that's what you're doing, I'm glad you're here. Thanks for being here. I'm sure when Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia wrote this song back shortly after the Altamont Festival disaster, I'm sure they were not really thinking in terms of, like, this would be kind of an anthem for years and years to come that doesn't, a lot of people don't even relate it to Altamont. They just relate it to one way or another, this darkness has got to end, or this darkness has got to give, I'm sorry. One way or another, this darkness has got to give. And that's the way, you know, a lot of us are feeling right now. One way or another, this darkness has got to give. But, this one's called the New Speedway Boogie. Try that again. One, two, three.
If you got nothing new to say, if you please don't back up the track, the train got the road today. I spent a little time on the mountain, I spent a little time on the hill. I heard some say better run away, others say better stand still. Just as hard with the weight of lead. can deny? Who can deny? It's not just a change of style. One foot down and another begun, and I wonder just how many miles. I spent a little time on the mountain. I spent a little time on the hill. I've seen things getting out of hand, but I guess they always will. I don't know now, but I've been told in the heat of the sun, a man died of cold. You keep on pushing or stand and wait with the sun so hot and the hour so late. You can't overlook the light, jack of every little thing. You can't overlook the light, jack of any other highway to ride. It's got no sign or dividing line, and very few rules to guide. I spent a little time on the mountain. I spent a little time.
I'm gonna do two more songs for you, and this is one that I always have a, for some reason I always have a tough time getting through it, even though I've been playing it almost longer than any of these songs. But it's just a weird timed song, and hopefully tonight I'm gonna get through it. Okay, I'm gonna get through it and not mess it up, because this is one of those songs that feels like communion. It feels like when all the Grateful Dead people come together, and all the people of the world and all the people that have any sort of reference to the Grateful Dead come together at these big festivals. This is one of those songs that just feels like you want to sing it around a campfire. And yet if you're a musician and you try to play this song, you realize it's not an easy song to play. It's one of those songs that sounds really easy, and then it's very difficult to play, like a lot of the Grateful Dead songs are. I've had so many, these days it seems like more and more of the top musicians are realizing that what a great legacy the Dead have. But there was a time, especially like in the 90s, I think, when a lot of people that consider themselves to be really great musicians were kind of like dissing on the Dead and saying, oh yeah, it's like Noodle Fest, just a bunch of hippies twirling around, nobody going anywhere. No, but no, this band sustained a legacy for now five decades, 50 years, because their songs are so great, okay? And if you try to play these songs, and take it from me, because I was one of those people that I didn't diss them,
But I thought, well, that's not really difficult until I started learning the catalog. Because I had to learn the catalog. When I started playing with Bill Kreutzmann, I had to learn like 50 Grateful Dead songs overnight. You know, and I started like, wow, this shit is hard. It's not easy, okay? So anyway, this is one of those songs that sounds very simple, and it's very deceptively difficult. And if I mess it up, well, sue me.
Well, the first days are the hardest days. Better take my advice. You know the easiest street.
I'm sorry, I already messed it up. See? I'm going to start over, okay? All right, get it together. All right.
First days are the hardest days. Don't you worry anymore. Cause when life looks like easy street, there is danger at your door. Think this through with me. Let me know your mind.
I cursed it when I said that, when I gave it that intro. You know what? Is there Wi-Fi here? Because I'm traveling. I'm flying without a lyric sheet, and that's the problem. I have. I'm gonna pull the lyrics up because I love this song so much and I want to do it justice. So let's do this right, okay? I thought I had it memorized, and I should have it memorized because I've only sang it about a million times. But I'm having a brain ripple. Okay. Actually, it looks like I may already be online. Let me see. That would be great if I was.
You're on sidebar guest.
I might, you know, because I played here before, I might be.
Yeah.
Oh, looks like I am. Well, that's easy. Okay, great, great, mm-hmm. great. Okay, we're going to start over, folks. Say, rewind. Okay. Okay, we're gonna try this again, all right? And after this one, we're gonna do one more song, and then we're gonna go home. And thank you so much for joining us tonight, for the celebration, really a celebration of the wonderful music of Robert Hunter and Jerry Garcia. Here's to Bob and Jerry. Okay, I got it now. I got this. I might mess up a chord or two, but.
Well, the first days are the hardest days. Don't you worry anymore. Cause when life looks like easy street, there is danger at your door. Think this through with me. Let me know your mind. It's a buck dancer's choice, my friend. Better take my advice. You know all the rules by now, and the fire from the ice. Will you come with me? Won't you come with me? Whoa, what I want to know. Will
walls are built of cannonballs. Their motto is don't tread on me. Come hear Uncle John's band play into the tide. Come with me or go alone. He's come to take his children home. It's the same story the crow told me. It's the only one he knows. Like the morning sun comes and like the wind you go. Ain't no time to hate, barely time to wait. Whoa, what I want to know, where does the time go? I live in a silver mine, and I call it Beggar's Tomb. I got me a violin, and I beg you call the tune. Anybody's choice, I can hear your voice. Whoa, what I want to know, how does the song go? Come hear Uncle John's band by the riverside. Got some things to talk about here beside the rising tide. Come hear Uncle John's band play into the tide. Come on along, go alone. He's come to take his children home.
Made it. Only one or two screw ups, but. All right, folks, this is the last song, and it always feels appropriate for the last song of the evening somehow, because it's like closure somehow, you know, it's like closure. And once again, I want to dedicate this to the great Robert Hunter and the great Jerry Garcia, who wrote the song and who are both in another place right now, who both passed on to the next life. And this song always seems appropriate for that somehow. So I'm going to leave you with Black Muddy River. And I hope you've had a good time. And I hope, again, that you've tuned in, you've enjoyed yourself, and that you will tune in again. Because this is how we live now. This, musicians, this is my new gig. I will see you again soon. I don't know when. I think I'm going to not do it like every week or twice a week. I think it's better to wait a little while and then get some enthusiasm for it, just like I would do on a local show or something. You know, I don't want to play like, you know, 3 or 4 times a week and then nobody really thinks that it's an event anymore. So if you had a good time tonight, please tell all your friends about it. Please tune in again next time and share. When I post something like this, just share it. That makes such a big difference, because it's like that snowball effect, you know, like I saw that like 50 people had shared my post today, and that means that all of their friends saw it, and some of those people will tune in, and some of those people will stumble on it by accident, but all of it helps. And right now, musicians, not just me, but musicians in general, we need all the help we can get. Not just musicians, but like promoters, publicists, venues. There's a lot of historic venues that are in danger of closing down right now. My favorite venue in this whole city is Tipitina's, and they're worried about not being able to stay alive. And my good friends Galactic bought Tipitina's last year, and the whole city was so excited that it was in good hands, because Galactic is, not only are they a great band, but they have huge fan base, and they have great business sense. And we just knew that Tipitina's was going to be okay because Galactic bought Tipitina's. But now they're worried about losing it because they can't supplement it with their income that they get from touring, and there's no shows coming through Tipitina's to make money at Tipitina's. And so, and that's not the only one. That's just probably the most famous one. There's a lot of, like the Maple Leaf Bar, same thing. I've been playing the Maple Leaf Bar and Tipitina's since the early 80s. Those two venues helped build my career, and I couldn't be more grateful. So please, just if you can, just support live music. And thank you for supporting me tonight, and thanks for tuning in. And all right, I'm getting all emotional again. I better stop it. I'm going to leave you with this song, which is a very beautiful, emotional song. And it kind of seems like an appropriate song to close out on. Hopefully I won't screw it up. I want to thank Sidebar Nola, because they're having a hard time hanging on, too. So, yeah. I'm so lucky they're hosting me tonight. And my buddy Keith over here. Or Klaus, as I like to call him. But he pours my drinks, and that's, you know, basically that keeps me happy.
Now
so,
the engineer, too.
And he's he's engineering, too. So if it sounds good, if it looks good, you can thank Klaus. Or Keith, as I like to call him. All right.
When the last rose of summer pricks my finger, and the hot sun chills me to the bone, when I can't hear my song for the singer, and I can't tell my pillow from a stone, walk alone by the black muddy river and sing me a song of my own. I will walk alone by the black muddy river and sing me a song of my own. With the scream of an eagle on the fly. troubles as they moan. I will walk alone by the black muddy river and sing me a song of my own. Black muddy river, roll on forever. I don't care, people, why, if you got another side. Roll muddy river, roll muddy river, black muddy river, roll. When it seems like the night will last forever, and there's nothing left to do but count the years, when the strings of my heart begin to sever, and stones fall from my eyes instead of tears, dream me a dream of my own. Sing me a song of my own. Dream me a dream of my own. Sing me a song of my own. Sing of my own.
Thanks everybody for tuning in. This is Papa Molly, your friend, the guy you've known all these years. Thank you for your love and your support. We'll see you next time. Good night. Black Lives Matter.